Good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to start chapter number 4, The Treasure Within, of our book, It So Happened. This is a story of a half-fish contractor, an average student, but how he found focus in his life, how he got into the profession of architect. All this is told in this chapter. Let us start reading. Hafiz Contractor was an unhappy schoolboy. He was not a very happy boy when he went to school. He loved doing things, but detested mechanical learning. He loved to do the things practically, but didn't like to go ahead with the theory and doing the things mechanically, like machines. Mathematics gave him the shivers. So mathematics was a subject which he didn't like, and at the thought of the subject, he started shivering. What his principal once said to him influenced him deeply. So once his principal told him something which influenced him very much and which changed his life. HC is Hafiz Contractor and BR is Bela Raja. She is a lady who is taking an interview of Hafiz Contractor. So in this whole chapter, we'll just listen to the interview of, we'll read the interview of Hafiz Contractor and Bela Raja. I used to have this terrible nightmare. Only now, over the last 4 to 5 years, it seems to have disappeared. जो हाफिज कॉन्ट्रैक्टर टॉक्स अबाउट हिज टेरिबल नाइटमेयर, भयानक सपने की बात करते हैं. एंड ही सेज दैट इट इज ओनली 4 to 5 years कि उनको वो नाइटमेयर जो है उनके नींद में से डिसअपियर हो गया. अदरवाइज टिल सो मेनी इयर्स ही हैड दैट सेम नाइटमेयर. व्हाट नाइटमेयर आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट एंड व्हाई डू यू थिंक इट हैज डिसअपियर्ड नाउ? सो बेला राजा द इंटरव्यूअर, शी आस्क्ड what is the nightmare which you are talking about and why do you think that that nightmare has disappeared now? I used to get continuous nightmares about appearing for a math examination where I did not know anything. Now the psyche must have gotten over it. I don't have to think about education and there is absolutely no time to get nightmares. So Hafiz Contractor gives the reason that I used to get continuous nightmares about appearing in math exam. Happens with many of the students, I think, that math is always a difficult subject for everyone. So it was the same with Hafiz Contractor. He felt that he had nightmares where he is sitting in an examination hall and there is a math paper in front of him and he doesn't know anything. And to the second question, that why do you think it has disappeared now? He says that now the psyche must have gotten over it. Psyche means mind. Now I think my mind must have gotten over that nightmare. As I don't have time, I don't think about education now. I don't think about studies now. And there is absolutely no time to get nightmares. And now my life is so busy that I don't have time to think about my nightmares. Bela Raja, tell us something about your earlier memories in school. Now she asks about the memories which he had. In the first and second year, I was a good student. After I reached the third standard, I simply lost interest and I never studied. So he says that till second standard, he was a good student. But in third standard, he started losing interest in study. And he did not perform well in his studies. I used to be interested in games, running around, playing jokes and pranks on others. What he liked all day was playing games, roaming here and there and playing pranks with others. I would copy in class during exam time. Aur exam time mein nakal maar ke main kaam kar leta tha. I would try to get hold of examination paper that had been prepared and study it. So he said that ki main kya koshish karta tha, that I should get hold of एग्जामिनेशन पेपर, किसी तरह मुझे एग्जाम का पेपर मिल जाए, मैं सिर्फ उतना ही पढ़ता था सो दैट आई कुड क्लियर माय क्लास. मैं कॉपी करता था एग्जाम में और आई ट्राई टू गेट होल्ड ऑफ दैट पेपर एंड आई प्रिपेयर्ड ओनली दैट मच विच यूज टू कम इन एग्जाम. एज आई कुड नॉट रिमेम्बर थिंग्स दैट हैड बीन टॉट टू मी इन क्लास. क्यों? क्योंकि मैं वो सारी चीजें याद नहीं रख सकता था जो मुझे क्लास में पढ़ाई जाती थी. However, later, one sentence spoken to me by principal changed my life. But फिर बाद में just one sentence which my principal said to me changed my whole life. Now let us read what she said. When I approached my 11th standard, the principal called me and said, "Look here, son, I have been seeing you from day one. You are a good student, but you never studied. I have taken care of you till today. Now I can no longer take care of you, so you do it yourself." So principal ne bulaya ek din usko jab he was in 11th standard. So the principal of the school called him aur unhone kaha ki wo unhe day one se dekh rahi hain. Then the principal said that I have been seeing you from day one. It means that she is talking about his childhood days when he entered the school. And the principal said that tab se leke ab tak I have taken care of you. You are a good student, but you never bothered to study. Tum kabhi bhi padhai tumne nahi ki. Now I can no longer take care of you, so you do it yourself. Ab main aur zyada tumhari help nahi kar sakti, to isliye tum apne aap cheeze manage karo. Now you have to study. He talks to me for 5 minutes. You don't have your father. Your mother has worked so hard to bring you up and paid all your fees all these years, but you have only played games. Now you should rise to the occasion and study. Now what he said, he says that for 5 minutes his principal talks to him. And what did she say? He, you are a fatherless child, you don't have your father, and your mother has worked very hard to bring you up. Tumhe palne poshne ke liye tumhari mother ne bahut hard work kiya hai. She has paid all your fees all these years, but you have only played games. Par tumne kya kiya hai? Sirf games play ki hain. Now you should rise to the occasion and study. Rise to the occasion means now you should prove yourself as per the demand of the time. Ab ye time demand kar raha hai that you prove yourself. I used to be very good sportsman. I had been the senior champion for so many years and I also was the cricket captain. I used to play every game, but that year I did not step out onto the field. So Hafiz contractor says that he was a very good sportsman. He was the captain, he was the senior champion, and for many years he was the captain of the team, cricket team. But that year when he was in 11th standard, when his principal talked to him, he did not step out in the ground. He did not go in the field. Wo khelne nahi gaya. I would go for prayers and all I would do was to eat and study. Main sirf bahar prayers ke liye jata tha. And what I would do, just eat and study. I normally used to copy and pass. Normally मैं क्या करता था, क्लासेस जब होते थे मैं कॉपी करता था काम और पास हो जाता था. But I realized that once I was in SSC, I could not do that. पर मैंने ये realize किया कि जब मैं SSC means senior secondary class में पहुंच गया, मैं ये काम नहीं कर सकता. Means I can't copy and pass. When I got a second class, Anji, when I got a second class, 60% in my SSC, my principal said, "Son, consider yourself as having got a distinction. This is my memory of my school days." So, जब मैंने अपनी SSC में 50% marks लिए, तो मेरे principal ने मुझे encourage करते हुए कहा कि अपने आप को एक इसमें एक distinction समझो. Distinction means extra, right? So because he was a child who copied and passed, then he scored 50% with his own hard work. So he was encouraged by the teacher and praised by the teacher, principal, and he says that this is my memory of my school days. Only that much I remember about my school days. I did lots of other things. See, as far as my things are concerned, I can't remember. So, कहते हैं मैंने और बहुत सारी चीजें की हैं, पर जहां तक if you talk about the things, the material or the details of the other things, I can't remember anything. I'm like that only, that I forget the things. I forget things very easily. To remember, I have to see things as a photograph. और अगर मुझे कोई चीज याद रखनी है तो मुझे उसे in the form of photograph देखना पड़ेगा. This is how, there are a few students beta who learn when they see the pictures. It is easy for them to grab the things when they see it in the form of pictures. There are students for whom it is easy to remember when they listen it from someone, and there are students who find it easy when they read the content themselves. So variety of students we do have. So he was the kind of a student who remembered the things only when he saw them. And he says that I read a book and I can remember the matter as a photograph, but not through my mind. वो कहता है कि मैं अगर कोई content पढ़ता हूँ, I can remember that through a picture, but not through my mind. If I read that, I can't retain that for long in my mind. But if I see a picture, then it becomes quite easy for me to remember the thing. That is how it works. My brain functions like that only. Then Bela Raja asked, when you were in school and you were doing badly, did the teachers pull you up and how did you feel? And next question is, जब आप स्कूल में थे एंड यू डिड द थिंग्स वेरी बैडली, क्या तुम्हारे टीचर्स तुम्हें स्कोल्ड करते थे? पुल यू अप मींस स्कोल्डेड यू, हाउ डिड दे एवर स्कोल्ड यू एंड हाउ डिड यू फील एट दैट टाइम व्हेन दे स्कोल्डेड यू? आई नेवर फेल्ट एनीथिंग ऑन बीइंग पुल्ड अप. मैंने कभी कुछ फील ही नहीं किया डांट खाने के बाद. आई यूज टू बी सो इंटरेस्टेड इन प्लेइंग. मैं खेल में इतना ज्यादा इंटरेस्टेड था. आई would receive a caning every week. And I was the kind of a student who was scolded, who was beaten up by the teachers every week. Then Bela Raja asked, when you knew that you had incurred the wrath of your teacher by not doing your homework or by behaving badly, then you knew you would get a caning, what was the state of your mind? The next question which she asked, ki jab tumhe pata tha, you have incurred the wrath of your teacher, means you have made your teacher angry. Kaise? By not doing your homework or by behaving badly with the teacher? Or when you knew that you are going to get punishment, right? You are going to get caning. Caning means tick ke saath pitai hona. So what was the state of your mind? Us time pe tumhara state of mind kya tha? State of mind? Just lift up a hand and that, and they would can you. It would hurt badly and then I would have to forget about it because I would want to go and play. So, kehta state of mind, mujhe nahi kuch pata. Jab mere canning hone lagti thi, I just lifted up my hand. I received the canning and it hurt at that time. It hurt badly. I felt bad and then I would forget about everything and what I was interested in was just going out to play. You never felt insecure or threatened? क्या तुमने कभी अपने आप को insecure, unsafe या threatened नहीं feel किया? I was just interested in playing and nothing else. मैं सिर्फ खेलने में interested था और किसी भी चीज में नहीं था. I was most interested in funny pranks. मैं ज्यादातर funny pranks में interested था. One day I did not want to study, so I created a distraction. For one whole hour we played chor police. Now one day he was sitting in the class. He did not want to study, so he created distraction, means disturbance in the class. And which game did they play? Chor police, right? Every Saturday we were allowed to go into town to see a movie. Every Saturday, unko kya allowed tha? Maybe they were. He was living in the hostel, so every Saturday it was allowed to the students to go and see a watch a movie. So what I would do was have no lunch and collect money from 40-50 students and run and buy the ticket. On my way back, I would eat to my heart's content. मैं क्या करता था? I didn't take lunch. मैं lunch time में lunch नहीं करता था. I used to go and collect money from 40-50 students. उन लोगों से पैसा इकट्ठे करके मैं movie के tickets लेता था. And on my way back home और वापस आते हुए I would eat to my heart's content. मैं अपना पेट भर के दिल भर के खाना खाता था with that money which you used to collect. I used to be the leader of a gang. मैं gang का leader था. We would have gang fights and plan strategies. हमारी gang fights होती थी और हम कई strategies plan करते थे to defeat our other gangs. These things used to interest me more than any academics. So ये सारी चीजें gang fights, making strategies, going out for movies, playing, all such things they attracted me a lot instead of studies. Students used to book my textbook for the following year because they were almost brand new. I probably opened them one day before exams. और जो बाकी other students होते थे वो पहले ही अगले साल के लिए मेरी books book कर देते थे. क्यों? क्योंकि उनको पता था कि मेरी बुक्स ब्रांड नहीं होगी. What was the reason? Because I never studied. I opened the book only a day before. और एक दिन पहले अगर आप बुक से पढ़ रहे हैं, एग्जाम के एक दिन पहले अगर आप बुक से पढ़ रहे हैं तो कितनी को गंदी हो सकती है आपकी बुक. So this was the reason that everyone felt my books were brand new almost. So they booked my book for the next year. Next is Bela Raja asked, how did you get into the field of architecture? So फिर आप इस field में कैसे आए? How did you get a chance to be an architect? In the college for architecture, nobody who had got below 80-85% was allowed to enter. I had only 50%. वो कहता है कि उस college में 80-85% से कम marks वाले बच्चों को enter नहीं करते थे. They were not given the admission in the college. But I only had 50% marks. I wanted to join the army. I got my admission letter, but my aunt tore it up. Then I decided that I wanted to join the police force. उसने कहा मुझे आर्मी ज्वाइन करनी थी. आई गॉट माई एडमिशन लेटर फ्रॉम आर्मी ऑल्सो बट माई आंट स्टोर दैट लेटर. उन्होंने टियर कर दी वो लेटर बिकॉज दे डिडंट वांट मी टू ज्वाइन आर्मी. एंड देन व्हाट डिड आई डिसाइड कि मैं पुलिस फोर्स ज्वाइन करूंगा. माई मदर सेड डोंट ज्वाइन द पुलिस फोर्स, जस्ट डू योर ग्रेजुएशन. सो आई वेंट टू जय हिंद कॉलेज इन बॉम्बे बट माई मदर इवन शी डिडंट अलाउ मी टू ज्वाइन पुलिस फोर्स. एंड देन आई वेंट टू डू ग्रेजुएशन फ्रॉम Jai Hind College in Bombay. There I was to either take French or German. और उस कॉलेज में या तो मुझे French या फिर German as an optional subject पढ़ना था. So I had studied French for 7 years. I didn't know 7 words of French. तो कहते चाहे मैंने 7 साल के लिए French पढ़ी थी बट मुझे French के 7 words तक नहीं पता थे. So this is what he is trying to tell, that for 7 years he studied French, but he was never interested in study, so he didn't know even the 7 words of French. So I took German. इसलिए उसने German language ले ली. Then my German teacher died, और फिर मेरे जो German teacher थे वो बेचारे मर गए. The college told me that I could change the college or take French. फिर कॉलेज वालों ने मुझे बताया बोला कि या तो मैं फ्रेंच एज अ सब्जेक्ट ऑप्ट कर लूं या अपना कॉलेज चेंज कर लूं. नाउ हु वुड गिव मी एडमिशन इन अनदर कॉलेज, और अब मुझे दूसरे कॉलेज में कौन एडमिशन देगा. आई हैड गॉट एडमिशन टू जय हिंद बाय इन्फ्लुएंस. इन्फ्लुएंस मीन्स अप्रोच. मैंने जय हिंद कॉलेज में भी जो एडमिशन ली थी वो किसी की अप्रोच के साथ ली थी. सो आई थॉट ओके आई विल टेक फ्रेंच. मैंने फ्रेंच ले ली फिर से एंड आई स्टार्टेड लर्निंग फ्रेंच अगेन. और मैंने दोबारा से फ्रेंच सीखनी शुरू कर दी. आई लर्नड इट फ्रॉम माय कजन, शी वाज एन आर्किटेक्ट वाइफ. और मैंने फ्रेंच किससे सीखना शुरू किया? अपनी एक कजन से. और वो कजन जो थी वो आर्किटेक्ट की वाइफ थी. आई वॉज गोइंग टू एन आर्किटेक्ट ऑफिस टू लर्न फ्रेंच. और मैं एक आर्किटेक्ट के ऑफिस में फ्रेंच सीखने के लिए जाया करता था. BR, that is Bela Raja. Was it then that you decided you wanted to do architecture? क्या ये तब था जब आपने डिसाइड किया कि आप आर्किटेक्चर का कोर्स करना चाहते हैं? हाफ इज कॉन्ट्रैक्टर. एक्चुअली इट ऑल हैपेंड क्वाइट बाय चांस. ये जो सारी चीज थी एक्चुअली ये बाय चांस ही हो गई. आई इन द आर्किटेक्ट ऑफिस आई सॉ समबडी ड्रॉइंग अ विंडो डिटेल. अब मैं आर्किटेक्ट के ऑफिस में जाता था फ्रेंड सीखने अपनी कजन से, तो मैंने देखा कि वहां पे एक आर्किटेक्ट जो था वो विंडो ड्रॉ कर रहा था. और सॉरी बेटे, आई सॉ समबडी ड्रॉइंग अ विंडो डिटेल्स. अ विंडो डिटेल इज वेरी एडवांस ड्रॉइंग. और जो विंडो डिटेल है वो काफी एडवांस ड्रॉइंग होती है. आई टोल्ड हिम दैट हिज ड्रॉइंग वॉज रॉन्ग, दैट द विंडो ही हैड ड्रॉन वुड नॉट ओपन. मैंने उसको बताया कि ये ड्रॉइंग तुम्हारी गलत है, जो तुम विंडो ड्रॉ कर रहे हो ये विंडो ओपन नहीं होगी. ही देन हैड अ बेट विद मी एंड लेटर ही फाउंड दैट इनडीड हिज ड्रॉइंग वाज रॉन्ग. उस टाइम पे उसने मेरे साथ शर्त लगाई कि मेरी जो मैं विंडो ड्रॉ कर रहा हूँ जब वो बनेगी तो ओपन हो जाएगी, बट लेटर ही फाउंड दैट एक्चुअली वो विंडो नहीं ओपन हुई. My cousin's husband was surprised. मेरे कजन के हस्बैंड जो थे वो काफी सरप्राइज थे. He asked me to draw a few specific things which I immediately did. And his cousin's husband was an architect. तो उसने उनको बोला कि you draw a few things. जब उसने कुछ चीजें draw करी, he told him to draw a few things. He immediately did that. फटाफट उसने वो सारी चीजें draw कर दी. He asked me to design a house and I designed a house. फिर उसने मुझे कहा एक घर का डिजाइन बना के दिखाओ, तो मैंने एक घर का डिजाइन बना दिया. After that, he told me to drop everything and join architecture. और उसके बाद उसने मुझे बोला कि तुम सब कुछ छोड़ दो and join this course. We went to meet the principal of the college. Then he with the his husband's cousins, both of them went to meet the college principal. The principal warned me, I will not allow you to take part in the entrance exam, but if you do not do sorry, I will allow you to take part in the entrance exam, but if you do not do well, I will not allow you to join. So principal ne warning di usko ki okay, because he did not score well, right? He had 50%, whereas the requirement was 80-85%. It was just by influence. He got admission in Jai Hind College, and now this time he went to meet principal, and the principal gave him the warning that okay, you are allowed to sit in the entrance exam, but if you don't perform well, I will not allow you to join college. I got an A+ in the entrance exam, and from that day it was a cakewalk. और मैंने उस दिन A+ लिया उस एंट्रेंस एग्जाम में, और उसके बाद मेरी लाइफ की इट वाज अ स्मूथ राइड. केक वॉक मीन अ स्मूथ राइड. इट वाज अ वेरी स्मूथ राइड. आई हैड नेवर मेड अ प्लान. मैंने कभी भी कोई प्लान नहीं बनाया था, बट आई न्यू हाउ समथिंग लुक्ड लाइक फ्रॉम द टॉप. पर मुझे ये पता था कि अगर कोई चीज टॉप से देखते हैं तो वो कैसी दिखती है. I stood first class first throughout after that. और उसके बाद मैं हमेशा ही first class में pass हुआ. I believe that all this understanding came from what I used to play and do during school. और मुझे ये लगता है कि हर चीज की understanding मेरे में तब आई जब मैं school में खेलता था, right? During school time जब मैं खेलता था. I had a friend called Behram Divecha. We used to have competitions between us for designing forts, guns and ammunition. Now he talks about one of his friends whose name was Behram Divecha. Both of them had competitions. What kind of competitions? They designed forts, kile banana, guns banana or ammunition means goliya, right? Wo banana usko competition hota tha unme. Each of us would design something in an effort to be different. और हम दोनों ही effort करते थे, ऐसी चीजें design करते थे इस effort में कि हम दूसरे से अलग दिखें, अलग बनाएं चीजें. In school, when I was in second or third standard, one of my teachers, Mrs. Gupta, saw my sketches and told me, see, you are useless in everything else, but your sketches are good. When you grow up, you become an architect. I didn't know that at that time, but she was right. Later, after I became an architect, I went back to meet her and tell her. So, but today we will stop here. We'll continue our lecture tomorrow. We'll start from the same paragraph which we are leaving at, and I hope that the chapter is clear to you till this paragraph.